How many batteries do I need to power my house? This is a really popular question that we get from you guys on the channel all the time. And this is a very logical question. Everyone's power consumption and needs are slightly different, yet a lot of people love pretending that there's a one-size-fits-all solution. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Not only do we exist as a resource to help you guys spend your hard-earned money wisely, but we also want to help you guys understand the technology without needing an electrical degree. We will leave links and discount codes down below in the description to any products that we talk about today to help you guys save some money if you're interested. But to answer the question, how many batteries do I need to power my house? Here's where we start. Part one is how much power does my house currently use? This is actually like a three-step process. Good news is each step gets just a little bit easier and a little bit faster to do. So part one, how much power does my house currently use? This is actually pretty easy to figure out. Your monthly electric bill has your consumption on it. It's a really good place to start. The thing with your electricity bill is it only gives you a rough estimate. For example, my last electricity bill for October said I used about 469 kilowatt hours for the month. If you divide that by 30, I used roughly 15.6 kilowatt hours per day. We would recommend though, trying to log into your utility's website or even calling if you have to get the daily breakdown. Because once you go ahead and actually look at the days within the month, you realize that a lot of days, maybe you don't use a lot of power, but there are some days that are very power hungry. And those numbers actually go far beyond the 15 point whatever kilowatt hours that my math said. So if I did this whole math on the 15 kilowatt hours, there are days where I would use more power than I had stored. I think the simplest thing that we would recommend doing is take your highest day on your highest month and use that as your target, because you know that compared to that number, the rest of the year you should be completely fine. For me personally, my biggest day is in the summer when the AC is pumping just nonstop. This summer, we actually had a really, really hot summer. My biggest day was about 40 kilowatt hours of consumption. And with that being said, the average home in the US uses about 30 kilowatt hours a day. So I wasn't high over the average mark. And if you just want something simple and everything I've said so far seems like way too much work, just use the 30 kilowatt hours per day benchmark, which is like the average in the US. But know that you might have days like I did where you use way more than you were expecting if you go on just a rough guess. All this is also assuming that you want to run your house like normal. If you're just trying to do emergency backup power and you're just trying to run the essentials, I would say it's safe to cut that number in half. So if you were to try to figure out how many batteries you need just based off step one alone, we're gonna use the 40 kilowatt hour number for whole home backup. You would need three 280 amp hour indoor wall mount batteries from EG4. If you were running the 20 kilowatt hour number because you were just trying to do essentials for home backup and emergencies, you could do two of the indoor 280 amp hour wall mount batteries, which is gonna give you way more power than you need. It's about 30 kilowatt hours. Or for less money, you could get four of the 100 amp hour indoor wall mount batteries, which will give you a more accurate battery storage number compared to how much you actually need, and it will save you a bunch of money. So part two is how long do you need power for? What you really want to find out here is what is your goal? Are you trying to power your house all day, every day? Or are you trying to power your house just in the case of emergencies and have backup power when a natural disaster happens? There's no right or wrong answer here, but you do have to be honest with yourself and you have to have a rough idea. Typically, we don't have a lot of power outages, but we do get at least one good one every year. Last year we had that ice storm and we saw about 4 days without power. So we're gonna use that as an example. We're gonna use 4 days as our number. If we needed 40 kilowatt hours per day for 4 days, we would need 160 kilowatt hours to continue to use our house like normal for that time. And if you were to cut that in half for the essentials, that would be about 80 kilowatt hours, which still sounds insane because we haven't made it to part three. Part three is how do you plan to charge your batteries? There is also no right or wrong answer with this question, but you have basically two options, solar or no solar. If you plan to use solar, you have to be honest with yourself on where you live and how sunny it actually generally is. In that case, for us, I know that where we live, if there's a storm, there's likely probably no sun a day before and at least a few days afterwards. If you live somewhere like Florida, you might have a damn hurricane come through and the sun will come out a few hours later. So if that's you and you live somewhere like that where you can just rely on sunshine, you might only need enough power for 2 days just in case that sun really doesn't come back one day. If sun is consistent where you live, you really only need enough runway for like 1 day without sun. Because whenever that sun does come back, you can charge your batteries up and be on your way. So if you are in that group of living in Florida and very reliable sun, and you used 40 kilowatt hours per day using your house completely normally and only needing about 2 days of storage, because based on your math, you get sun pretty much every day, at worst every other day, you'd only need 80 kilowatt hours of battery storage, which is about 6 indoor 280 amp wall mount batteries, or 40 kilowatt hours if you were only using essentials, which is 3 280 amp hour indoor wall mount batteries. Your other choice here, if you don't have that reliable sun like we don't, is to charge it with the grid or a generator, which is honestly still a really good option, and I think a lot of people should take it a little more seriously. You can have your system tied to the grid so that it's always fully charged, that way whenever the power does go out, your system is full and ready to use. And if you use a gas generator in a smart way, you can actually only run it for like a couple hours per day, charge your system all the way back up to full, and then turn it back off, so you don't have to have that constant generator humming all the time. You just run it for a couple hours to charge your system, and then you're back to quiet. So in this example, say you had a gas generator, you could really just get enough batteries for 1 day, which is completely honestly what we do. So you would only need 1 day's worth of storage if you were to use the 40 kilowatt hour day as an example, using your house like normal, really extremely. You would be back to only needing 3 of those 280 amp hour indoor wall mount batteries from EG4. And you're back to only needing 20 kilowatt hours if you're trying to use essentials, which is 2 of those 280 amp hour indoor wall mounts, which gives you way more than you need, or 4 of the 100 amp hour wall mount batteries, which is cheaper than the 280 amp hour ones and more accurately sized. So if that's you and you're trying to run essentials, 20 kilowatt hours, and you have those indoor 100 amp hour wall mount batteries, if you had something like the 6,500 watt Champion generator, 3 hours of runtime would charge those batteries from 0 all the way to full, all of them in the essentials situation. Of course, you can get bigger generators that need to run less, and you can also get smaller systems that don't need as much power to charge them up, which is kind of what I do. I have a small system. I only need to run the generator for an hour a day to keep it charged up, maybe 2 hours if I forgot I was only supposed to be using the essentials and I was going absolutely ham cooking a turkey dinner. So honestly, that's how you figure out how many batteries you need. Our opinion here at the lab is if you're gonna be buying batteries, buy something like the EG4 batteries. You get server rack ones or the wall mount ones, whatever suits your needs best. But when you buy those batteries, you're getting real customer support. You can call in and have a good logical conversation about the products that you need. They will help you out. And if you have a problem, you actually have warranty and customer support that you can talk to. There is a lot of brands that, sure, they sell cheaper stuff, but it's hard for us to recommend it to you guys because if you have a problem, you're kind of on your own. If you have now figured out what size battery you need and you're trying to move on to like, what size inverter or solar array do I need? Check out the channel. We have a whole learn playlist full of informative videos like this to kind of help you guys figure out what it is exactly that you need. Otherwise, that's pretty much all that we got for you guys today. If you guys are not already, please make sure you subscribe and we will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.